Hello and welcome to episode 26 of Cling Spores Tech Talk. My name is Jessica Walker.
I am Nick DeMars.
And today we're going to be talking a little bit about wood. So softwoods versus hardwoods and what goes into differentiating those. So starting out, Nick, how can we distinguish a hardwood from a softwood?
Well, let me just turn that right back around on you.
Okay.
What do you think that distinguishes a hardwood from a softwood?
I mean, I guess one of them's hard and one of them's soft.
And that is a good part to it, actually. But there is a lot more to it than that. Some of the things that we can look at to distinguish a hardwood from a softwood as far as the tree is concerned are the leaves and the seeds. We'll go into detail about that a little bit more later. But leaves and the seeds are a good indicator.
Okay.
Also, the growth rate. You know, when we talk about growth rate, we're talking about how much a tree grows within a year's period of time. And as far as the softwoods are concerned, they grow at a really rapid rate. They grow really fast. The hardwoods grow much slower. Now, if you go out into the market where you see all these different kinds of woods for sale, you'll notice that the softwoods tend to be much less expensive than the hardwoods. And the reason for that is because of that growth rate. Because the softwoods grow so much faster, that they can produce that much more lumber, if you will.
Yeah.
And so, you know, with that being the case, it's a no-brainer that those things are going to be a good bit cheaper out in the market. And the last thing, just like you mentioned, the hardness and the mm-hmm. softness, we like to call that density. So we'll see a big density difference in the hardwoods and the softwoods, but you can't use that as the only determining factor because we have some softwoods that are very hard and mm-hmm. we have some hardwoods that are very soft.
Okay.
So that's just a general overall look at a little bit of distinguishing characteristics.
Okay. So can you explain a little bit more? I know you mentioned the leaves and seeds. Can you explain a little bit more on how they differentiate a hardwood versus a softwood?
Yeah, so let's say you're standing out into a patch of forest and you look around and you're seeing maple trees and you're seeing mm-hmm. oak trees, and then off to the little left a little bit you see some pine trees. Mm-hmm. What you're going to notice is that the hardwood trees, the leaves are broad and flat. So if you picture in your mind, I'm sure everybody out there has seen oak trees. Picture mm-hmm. in your mind that oak leaf. If you lay it out on the table, it lays out nice and flat. But then the softwood trees have needle-like leaves. So they'll all look like a bunch of needles sticking out, and we've all seen that as well. Even when it comes to the cedar, even though the needles on a cedar tree are kind of flat, they're still narrow and still look like a needle. So that's another one of them good distinguishing characteristics. As far as the seeds are concerned, softwoods, what we call coniferous trees, and that gets its name from the fact that they produce cones. What those cones are is a huge seed pod that carries a multiple of seeds within each pod, within each cone.
Gotcha.
So when that cone drops to the ground, it's gonna germinate a whole bunch of different trees around it. As opposed to that, the hardwood trees drop one seed at a time. It's not a bunch of seeds bundled together, but think about the acorn, for instance. Mm-hmm. When an acorn drops to the ground, what are you gonna get from that when it starts to grow? You're gonna get one tree, okay? So that's another distinguishing characteristic, is that the softwoods produce the cones, which are in fact a bundle of seeds, and the hardwoods produce single seeds. Interesting side note as well here, what we consider to be nuts mm-hmm. are actually seeds from hardwood trees.
Oh, yeah.
So if you think about the almond, for instance, mm-hmm. or the cashew is produced at the bottom of a fruit called the cashew apple. Mm-hmm. And from what I understand, I haven't ever tried it, but from what I understand, that cashew apple is actually edible. But at the bottom of that thing, you'll see this funny looking little shell shaped just like mm-hmm. a cashew.
Wow.
So there's the leaves and the seeds.
That's awesome. So another thing you mentioned was density. Can you kind of go into more detail about that and explain density?
Yeah, density is kind of a funny thing because you'll see it in different ways in different woods. And like I mentioned, you can't specifically judge every tree as being a hardwood or a softwood by the density. We have some hardwoods, like I mentioned earlier, that are very soft. For instance, consider the balsa tree.
Mm-hmm.
The balsa tree is a very light, spongy kind of wood. In fact, it's so light that when I was a child, they made airplanes out of it. You'd get three or four parts, you'd put them together, and you'd throw that thing, and it'd sail through the air mm-hmm. really well. That balsa wood is super light, it's super soft, but it's still a hardwood. On the other side of that coin, in the softwood variety, we have a yellow pine. Yellow pine is a very dense, very hard wood, but not the wood itself. It's very dense and very hard because it carries with it a lot of resin, a whole lot more resin than most other trees. As I was growing up in the construction industry and coming up and learning this and that, what I found out was the days that we had to drive nails into a yellow pine board were bad days because you would drive three or four nails, bend them over, and then you'd finally get one to go through. And of course, a lot of times that thing would split open and you'd have to drive another one in. But that yellow pine, even though it's a softwood, it's very hard. So you can't use the density alone to judge, you know, one tree from another.
Yeah.
And another difference that we see in you know, hardwoods and softwoods is a thing called pores.
What are pores? Why does wood need pores?
Okay. Sometime in the tree's life, actually throughout the whole cycle of life, the tree has to transmit nutrient-filled water all the way from the ground, up through the roots, through the bark, through the wood, the whole shot, and out to the branches, to the leaves, to the fruit that's produced, the seeds, so on and so forth. Hardwoods and softwoods do this in a totally different way. What hardwoods do, hardwoods have these things that we call pores. They're basically little channels, little canals. And you'll see that if you look at the end of a piece of oak wood, for instance. You can see the pores in that oak wood with the naked eye.
Wow.
But they're just little canals. They're called vessel elements, actually. And that pulls the water up through those canals, through those channels, and it, you know, disperses it out to the various elements of the tree. Softwood is a totally different ballgame. Softwood doesn't have pores. It has cells called trachids. And those trachids are, if you imagine, if you had a bunch of sponges attached together, okay, you take a sponge here, you sew another one to it here, sew another one to it here, so they stand up about this tall. And then you take that and you dip the bottom sponge only in a bunch of water, and you just hold it there. What you're going to see is that sponge is going to soak up the water, and then the next sponge is going to begin soaking up the water, and so on and so forth. That is exactly how softwood transfers that nutrient-filled water throughout the tree, just from one cell to another.
Just kind of, it's like a sponge, just soaks it up.
Exactly.
So when applying stain, is there any differences in hardwood and softwood when applying stain? Is there a noticeable difference?
Yeah, there is. There's different types of wood in each tree. What we call early wood and late wood. So from spring through summer, early wood grows. From fall through winter, late wood grows. The difference in those two is, again, has to do with the growth rate. So as the spring and the summer go on, the tree grows really, really fast. There's a lot of food for it, a lot of nutrients coming up in the soil. And then fall and winter hit, and it grows really slow. And so you'll see a difference not only in the way the wood acts, but the look of the wood as well. What you'll see, for instance, in a piece of pine wood, you'll see a light stripe, and then all of a sudden it's got a dark stripe. These two contrasts make up what we call rings in the butt cut of the tree.
Yep.
Okay? So what you'll see is the early wood that grows so fast is really soft. It soaks up water or stain or anything else like a sponge. The late wood is going to be more compact, more dense, more hard, and have a lot more resin in the case of the pine tree. So when you go to stain that, it's really interesting because that lighter part of the wood will soak up more stain than the darker part of the wood, and that contrast actually flips.
Wow.
All of a sudden, the darker part of the wood becomes the lighter part of the wood because it didn't soak up any stain. And the lighter part of the wood becomes the darker part of the wood because it soaked up a
ton
of stain.
Soaked it all up. Wow.
And so hardwoods don't have such a big contrast in the early wood and late wood. So when you stain a piece of hardwood, you get a good even coat of stain on that.
Oh, wow. That's awesome. So are hardwoods best used for specific jobs other than versus using softwoods?
Yeah, depending on what industry you look at. If you look, for instance, in the general construction industry, what you're going to see mostly is pine. Since softwoods are so much cheaper to produce, or, you know, they have a shorter life cycle, they're so much cheaper in the market, that's what's used for your framing, for a lot of your moldings, things that go into building a house. Now, when it comes to things like cabinetry, furniture, anything like that, the hardwood is more desirable because of the density, that what we talked about earlier.
Yep.
You can take a hammer and tap a piece of hardwood. Chances are you're not going to hurt it. You take a hammer and lightly tap a piece of softwood, you're going to put a dent in it. Mm-hmm. And something you and I talked about earlier today, and we grabbed a piece of pine, and you can stick your fingernail down in that early wood section.
Dent it.
And it'll make a dent.
Yeah,
that's exactly right.
It's crazy.
Now, on the late wood section, it's harder, more dense. It's not going to do it. But you can't do that to a piece of hardwood.
Wow.
So different industries use different kinds of wood. You will see, for instance, hardwood flooring. It's mostly hardwood. But from time to time, you'll see a pine floor, so on and so forth.
Gotcha. Wow. So when sanding, what are a few things to remember?
Well, one of the things to remember is you almost kind of got to kind of take what you want at the very end of the process and work backwards. For instance, you know, we talked about the softwoods being so soft, soaking up so much stain.
Yep.
Keeping that in mind while you're sanding is a big thing.
Yeah.
Because in a lot of instances, you might want to sand the softwood higher than you would the hardwood, because you know it's going to soak up that much more stain. You know, when we're sanding hardwood, there's an area where we want to stay in the middle of. If the wood starts out fairly rough, you, of course, you want to go low enough to start smoothing that down. But we don't want to go any higher than a certain point in that process, because if we do, we start closing off those pores that we talked about.
Yep.
And we make it to where the stain or the finish you're putting on can't adhere evenly to the surface.
Yep, I gotcha. So are there any differences in how to sand hardwood?
There is, yeah.
Softwood?
Yeah, very much so. And it was like I said a minute ago, you can take that softwood to a higher grit than you would the hardwood. You know, anytime you're sanding wood, the process that you're using has a lot to do with it. If you take a random orbital sander makes a bunch of little swirly marks as it's going, because it's spinning in a circle this way, but that pad is also being thrown off center, so it's making these pigtail marks. Well, if you stop and think about it, at some point in that pigtail mark, it's going to become a cross-grain scratch, which is something you don't want.
Right.
So we always try to recommend that for your last grit that you're going to sand that raw wood with, that you always go in the direction of the grain. And we'll talk about that more later.
Awesome. Well, that's all the questions I had for today. Definitely learned a ton about hardwood versus softwood. I didn't know almost any of that. So thank you for joining us. And of course, you guys know, any questions you may have, you're welcome to call us here in technical. Or you can email techtalk@clingspore.com. I think that is it for the day. So thank you for joining us, and we'll see you next time.